हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर तेजेंद्र सिंह. आई एम मेडिकल ऑन्कोलॉजिस्ट इन अपोलो हॉस्पिटल नवी मुंबई. टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट हार्मोन थेरेपी इन ब्रेस्ट कैंसर. हार्मोन थेरेपी इन ब्रेस्ट कैंसर इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट मोडेलिटी, ए काइंड ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट विच इज़ वेरी यूजफुल. एंड नॉर्मली वेन एवर वी ट्रीट एनी ब्रेस्ट कैंसर पेशेंट, वी सी वेदर द ट्रीटमेंट इज, वी कॉल इट एड ऑन थेरेपी और एडजुवेंट, or in a patient where the disease has spread, whether we have to use it in a, as a way of palliative therapy. So when we see in a patient of early stage breast cancer, normally we always do a testing called estrogen receptor testing, progesterone receptor testing, and if this come positive, we advise them to take hormone therapy for 7 to 10 years. The advantage of this treatment is that it is the cost effective, very less costly. The side effects are not like chemotherapy. There is nothing called hair fall, no nausea, vomiting, no incidence of any low counts. And the another importance is that it works very well for these patients. So we have to continue the hormone therapy for around 7 to 10 years. There are some patients we give them only for 5 years. But most of the patients, they take it for 7 to 10 years. Second is in the cases where the disease has spread. This is a separate category of patient where the disease has spread. Mostly the spread is to the bones. There also we use this hormone therapy. There are drugs which are used for hormone therapy. We call them tamoxifen, letrozole, anastrozole, exemestane. And they work very well for this particular group of patients. Apart from that, now there are newer advances which have come up over there. Since they are available in tablets, you need not get admitted for any kind of admission for, and the chemotherapy complication are not part of it. And new advances have led on to more new hormone therapy coming in place. There's an injection called fulvestrant, which is not an injection, it is not an intravenous, it is an intramuscular injection. Then newer drugs called CDK4/6 inhibitors, the name are palbociclib, ribociclib, and abivacyclib is there. Also, there is one new drug which is called PIK3 inhibitors, which are like alpicillin has come up in a big way. So patients who are having these receptors in their tumors, they should be offered hormone therapy. The advantage, like I said, is that they are not injections, they are nothing but tablets. Side effects are not like chemotherapy, hardly any side effects. And you can take it in the home, you don't require to get admitted. So wherever possible, make sure the patients who are having breast cancer, we should do the hormone testing. And wherever the hormones come positive, receptor comes positive, we should be given hormone therapy to them. Thank you.